This is the story of King Jehoshaphat and what we can learn from his life. King Asa, the father of Jehoshaphat, ruled over Judah. He did what was good and pleasing in the Lord's sight. But as the years go by, he starts putting his trust in armies, and when he gets sick, he did not seek the Lord. After his death, his son Jehoshaphat starts ruling. The Lord was with Jehoshaphat because he followed the example of his father in his early years. He did not worship the images of Baal and sought his father's God. He obeyed all of God's commands. As the years go by, Jehoshaphat became very wealthy and highly esteemed. He was deeply committed to the Lord's ways and also encouraged the people to return to the Lord. One day, the armies of the Moabites, the Ammonites, and some of the Munites declare war against Jehoshaphat. His messengers come and tell him that a vast army from Edom was marching against him from beyond the Dead Sea. They were already at Hazon Tamar. Hearing this, Jehoshaphat becomes very terrified. He begged the Lord for guidance and ordered everyone in Judah to start fasting. So people from all the towns of Judah came to Jerusalem to seek the Lord's help together. Jehoshaphat then stands before the entire community of Judah and Jerusalem in the courtyard of the Lord's temple. This is the prayer that he made. You alone are God in heaven and the ruler of all kingdoms on earth. God, you are powerful and you are mighty, and no one can stand against you. Whenever we face any calamity such as war, plague, famine, we can always come and stand in your presence before this temple where your name is honored. We can cry out to you to save us, and you will hear us and rescue us. Now God, see what the armies of Ammon, Moab and Mount Seir are doing. O our God, won't you stop them? We are powerless against this mighty army that is about to attack us. We do not know what to do, but we are looking to you for help. At that moment, the Spirit of the Lord came upon one of the people who were praying. He was Jahaziel, son of Zechariah, and he conveyed the Lord's message to Jehoshaphat and all the people gathered. He said, "Do not be afraid. Don't be discouraged by this mighty army, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Tomorrow, march out against them. They will come through the ascent of Ziz. But you will not need to fight. Take your positions and then stand still. Watch the Lord's victory, for He is with you. Do not be afraid or discouraged. Go out against them tomorrow, for the Lord is with you." Hearing this message, Jehoshaphat bows low to the ground. All the people did the same and worshipped the Lord. The Levites stood and praised the Lord with a very loud shout. Early the next morning, the army of Judah went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. On the way there, Jehoshaphat stopped and said to the people following him, "Believe in the Lord and you will be able to stand firm. Believe in his prophets and you will succeed." Jehoshaphat also appointed singers to walk ahead of the army, singing to the Lord and praising him for his glorious splendor. This is what they sang. "Give thanks to the Lord, his faithful love endures forever." Imagine walking into a battle with songs instead of weapons. At that very moment, they began to sing and give praise. The Lord caused the armies of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir to start fighting amongst themselves. First, the armies of Ammon and Moab fought against Mount Seir and killed them all. Then, The army of Moab and Ammon fought among themselves and finished it. When the army of Judah arrived at the lookout point in the wilderness, all they saw were dead bodies lying on the ground as far as they could see. Not a single one of the enemy had escaped. There was so much plunder that it took them 3 whole days just to collect it all. On the 4th day, they gathered in the Valley of Blessing and praised and thanked the Lord there. Then they returned to Jerusalem, overjoyed that the Lord had given them victory over their enemies. Then they marched into the Lord's temple to the music of harps, lyres, and trumpets. When the surrounding kingdoms heard that the Lord himself had fought against Israel's enemies, the fear of God came over them. Jehoshaphat's kingdom was at peace, for God had given him rest on every side. Are you wondering what battles have to do with us and what we can learn from the story of Jehoshaphat? Let's just take a look at Jehoshaphat's battle plan, shall we? When the battle approached, the first thing that Jehoshaphat did was to seek the Lord. He didn't run after people, he didn't run after armies, but he sought his Lord first. Step 2 was that he united the people of the entire nation for a common purpose, and that was to seek the Lord and find his will. The third was that he declared a fast and the entire nation fasted together for a common goal. The 4th step was that even though he was a king, he publicly humbled himself in front of everyone and surrendered everything completely into the Lord's hands. The 5th step was that he makes a fantastic prayer, talking about God's might and his goodness to them in all the past years. Step 6 was that he explained his current situation in prayer and accepted his own helplessness in front of this mighty army. And after the Lord's message does reach the people, Jehoshaphat does step 7, which was trusting God and obeying his word exactly. The Lord told them to march into the battlefield and stand still, and that is exactly what Jehoshaphat planned on doing. Step 8 was that not only Jehoshaphat was motivated to follow the Lord wholeheartedly, he also encouraged the people around him to keep the faith and stand firm till the end. Step 9 was that they walked into the battlefield singing, praising, and thanking God even before the battle began. And after the Lord does give them the victory, step 10 is that they don't forget to be grateful. They sing, praise, and thank God after he gives them the victory. Our battles might not be the same as Jehoshaphat's, but you can be sure that everybody faces their own battles in their own way. It might be a sickness, it might be a financial problem, it might be a difficult person in your life. It might even be a personal weakness. It might be a difficulty in studying. It might be relationships. It might even be an impossible situation. But remember Romans 8:37, which says that in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us, and that is Jesus Christ. In 2 Chronicles 20:15, we see that the battle is not ours, but God's. And when we surrender our battles into God's hands, we can be sure that we are not fighting this battle alone. So, what's your battle plan today?